Then one day I met John on set of Ford vs Ferrari, the movie, and he told me that he was. We kind of talked Russian a little bit with each other. You know, he talks Russian, and I'd be honest with you, I didn't know he's an actor or who he is. He was just a cool guy with a really handsome dog. He had a pit bulls, and pit bull is my favorite type of dog, and I would love to have a pit bull one day. He told me that, you know, if I am serious about pursuing acting here in America, I should take a theater in America, because I used to, you know, taking theater back home in Ukraine. But he's like, you have to take theater in English. You have to take theater in the language you're gonna act. You have to, you know, proceed with your martial arts training, but do it for real and focus on work, 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 or focus on your skill set. Like, just so he's like, if you're gonna, he's like, girl, if you're gonna put a work into the craft, one day the right people are gonna notice you. It's not gonna be unnoticed. And then they're gonna give you an opportunity, right? And if you're ready for it, you're gonna succeed. And then another opportunity come along and another.
You move, you die.
What was it like? It's your first role, right? Your like first real
Yeah.
role. What was it like?
I mean, first big role. I had some, you know, I mean, Day Shift was before that, but it's like little parts here and there. And there was a couple of more action films before that. But I consider this is my big breakthrough, you know. And at the same time, me and Taryn have to go on set of John Wick 4 in France. So here is life, right? It gives you your dream, but another dream to go in for me, right? To go in John Wick 4 in France. I'll have to sacrifice one of these. And I was heartbroken because, like, oh my God, how is it life? Like, why is this happening, right? For the whole year, you didn't have anything to happen. But then two things at the same time. The day we start Bosch and the day they start John Wick 4 in France and finish, it's the same time. So obviously I chose Bosch. And I remember they brought me on set, and it was a rehearsal day. They brought me on set, and they're like, okay, we have this scene. Choreograph it. How would you do it? So, that whatever you guys see right now, I was so happy. They gave me freedom to realistically choreograph it.
Saying hello.
You think your wife can hear you?
No.
Then why bother?
Maybe I'm wrong.
You're going to die.
Maybe not.
When you see this trailer, and knowing that you were a part of this movie, what does it do for you? Because this is a huge movie. Tatiana, this is huge.
Yeah, it's huge. It's one of the best action films ever made. And you know, when Chad invited me and Taryn, like, personally to watch the movie before it was finished edited, you know, he was sitting there and watching me cry and smile and just going through this journey of this movie, because this movie is so fantastic, you know. And I told Chad, you did something unbelievable. You took the franchise to the next level with action, with acting, you know, with the cast. And Taryn designed such unbelievably beautiful weapons never seen ever before. So the movie becomes so sleek and so amazing, you know. Just
Wait a minute.
it's
So Taryn actually designed the weapons for this movie?
Yeah, Taryn has been designing the weapons for this movie for since I think John Wick 2. That's
Really?
Keanu's weapons is Taryn Butler, Taryn Tactical Weapons, TTI.
I had no idea. I had no idea.
Yeah.
Try to do this as fast as you humanly possibly can, okay? Don't worry about safety, just go fast.
All right.
Shooter ready. Stand by.
You work with Jamie Foxx.
Yeah.
Was Day Shift for Netflix?
Yeah.
You did a little bit in there. You did your thing. How was it working with Jamie Foxx and Day Shift?
So, Day Shift is a movie on Netflix directed by J.J. Perry. And a lot of people don't know, but J.J. Perry is just like Chad Stahelski. Actually, J.J. Perry had worked on John Wick 2. He was like helping to do martial arts and choreography and all fights and stunts. And JJ is just like Chad Stahelski, right? They both were stunt people, right? Second unit directors. Mm-hmm. Stunt people in the beginning, then second unit directors. And now they both become directors. Gotcha. So this was JJ Perry, directorial debut with Jamie Foxx and Snoop Dogg. Again, Jamie is amazing. I feel I was very worried about him because he is in a hospital right now, but he's feeling better.
Yes,
and he just came up with a statement, and we all were really, really shocked and praying for him every day. I try to exercise and stretch 20 minutes a day, but sometimes my life getting so hectic and out of control that doing these clip like fun clips or actually doing it for real but not videotaping helps me to maintain my flexibility and my body. So it's really like that day I was actually doing it for real, and Taryn just videotaped that, and it was kind of cool because it helps me to maintain it, but at the same time, you know, I created content, and if I don't have those 20 minutes a day to stretch or work out, I'm gonna lose my flexibility. It's just how it is.
You recently met with your mom after seeing your mom for 8 years.
Yeah.
Does she understand what you're doing and that you're a big deal? Or is she just Tatiana, just Tatiana, her baby? Does she understand that, you know, you are what you wanted to be seeing the X-File show?
I don't know. It's a good question for my mom. I know I left home pretty young. Like, I left first to Poland, actually, where you know, my family is right now. I left to work there as a dancer. And I don't, but I don't know. It's a good question. Right now, I'm like in a really interesting conversation with my mom because I'm trying to, you know, bring them here so they can be a little closer to me so I can sleep good, right? Safe, because like having your family so far in Europe and with everything what's happening in my country and nobody even knows what's happening anymore, to be honest with you. So it's like I'm not in peace at all right now.
So
like last year when I was rescuing my family, like literally that boss show that I got and Day Shift checks and everything that I got, like that year my bank was empty, like zero. That's how much it all cost me just to help my family and my immediate friends back home. It's just, you literally just kind of give it all away. And then you understand that money, it helps you to cover the needs. But if something really happens, you understand how much you love your family. Mm-hmm. And you will do everything for them. And it's not a question about money anymore. Money comes and goes. And if you need to let it go, you just let it go. You just empty your bank like this. And you work harder to, you know, get some money back.